Hello everyone, welcome to Happy Learners, and this is our today's topic, which is how to repeat a sequence n number of times in UiPath using activities in UiPath Studio. Let's say for example we have a set of activities under a sequence, and we want to run that sequence. Let's say we want to run that sequence again and again and again 3 times, and let's see how we can do that. And now we directly go to UiPath Studio, and this activity is still in preview. And if you want to try out this activity, you need to go to manage packages first and then update your system.activities package to the preview 21.6.1 preview version. Then you will able to see this activity, otherwise this activity will not be available for you in the UiPath Studio. First update this, and then if you type here repeat number of times, you can see the activity here, repeat number of times. Just drag and drop that here. Let me also drag a message box over here so that we can check whether it is doing the right thing. Okay, let's talk about the properties of this activity. Here the input is the number of times, how many times it need to repeat the activities inside the do, this one, inside this activity, how many times it need to repeat those steps. Let's say we want it for 3 times here, and the other one is start at. I will tell you what is start at in the later point. Let's say now it is repeating for 3 times, it repeating the message box for 3 times. Let's give a blank statement here, a string RPA learners, and let me start the execution first. So it need to give the message box 3 times because we mentioned the repeat number of times is 3. So 1, 2, and 3. So these are the it executed 3 times, and now what is this current item here? So this current item is the value, how the row number, let's say when we use for each row is the for each row number. So let's see what is the value that is giving for the current item as well. This is not a static string, so it need to provide me the current item value. So the current item is 1, and it is 2, and it is 3, right? And now the current item is holding the value which is at start at. You can see the start at, whether current item starts with 0 or 1 or more. Let's say you need to run this for 3 times, and the value you need to start from is 2. Let's say you are using the value in somewhere around that particular sequence, and that need to be starts at 2. Let's say we have a switch case here, 2, 3, 4, and it need to go 2, 3, and 4. We need to ignore 0 and 1. Then I will mention it as 2 here, so it will start from 2. In the run before, we seen 1, 2 and 3. Now we will see 2, 3 and 4 because it is starting from 2, 3 and 4. See, it is 2, 3 and 4. So this is how you use repeat number of times activity in your UiPath Studio. And that's it for this video. If you like this video, give it a like. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please consider subscribing for more videos. Thanks for watching.